Hey, what's going on, good people? Welcome back to the Living the Life Show. I'm your host, Columbus Cody, and I thank you so much for joining me today for the verse of the day. Today's verse is a verse that you must, and I mean you must, add to your arsenal of verses for strength, okay? This verse will get you through any hardships. It's about changing the perspective of your pain. What you're going through has purpose. There's purpose in your pain. We just have to change our perspective. So let's check it out. This is James chapter 1, verse 2 and 3, and we're going to read the NLT, and this is what it says. Dear brothers and sisters, when trouble comes your way, consider it an opportunity for great joy. For you know that when your faith is tested, your endurance has a chance to grow. When your faith is tested, that's the key. You don't know how strong you are until you're forced to be strong. You don't know how patient you are until you're in a situation where it challenges your patience. You don't know how much you love God until you're in a position where compromise becomes an easy option. Some people give in to every whim and every temptation that comes along because they don't have the strength. And some of us, we think we have the strength. We even judge those who fall into temptation. But when the test hits us, that's when we find out who we really are. And see, the testing is needed, not for God to know what's in us, because He does know, but for Him to show us what's in us. And if you will stay strong and stay committed when the things hit, the hard things come, the things that need your patience, need your trust, need your endurance, you will come forth from that thing stronger, wiser, smarter, more trusting, more encouraging, because you've seen it. Until you go through it, it's hard for you to be the light to someone else about that thing. A lot of times we can talk about what we've heard, but when it's something you know, when you speak about something you know, you speak of it from a whole nother realm of confidence, a whole nother realm of convincing. See, it's a lot easier for a person who has been an alcoholic for 20 years to convince a struggling alcoholic right now that God can change them. God changed them and has kept them away from the bottle for 10 years, and they trust God that He can do it for anybody else. That person could convince another that God can give them the strength to overcome as well. Then you got the person who's never drank before, who's telling you all you got to do is trust God to give up that bottle. They've never drank. You're going to be a little bit less convincing than the person who gave it up after it robbed them of years of their life. So what am I saying? You need the testing to find out what you're made of. You need the struggle to find out how strong you are. You need the hardship for you to sometimes fall to your knees, pray and ask God for strength, and continue on the path. There's purpose to your pain. And if you trust God and lean on God, He will change your perspective while you're going through the pain. And then you will come to trust Him that, Lord, I don't know what I'm supposed to gain from this. I don't know why I'm going through this, but I trust that if You've allowed it in my life, that when I come forth from this, I'm going to be a better man, a better woman for it. And I trust You. And I pray that this verse encourages you like it has encouraged me, that no matter what you're going through, there's purpose in it if God is in it. That's the key. All right. It's the verse of the day, good people. Make sure you share it with at least one person. Make sure you like, subscribe, and click the bell. I'm going to say it one more time. Like, subscribe, and click the bell. Do it right now. Don't leave until you do it. All right. Make sure you watch it, share it, and live it. Now let's get busy living the life.